This is ABC 7 News, Chicago's number one news, with Stacy Baca, Kevin Roy, and weather with meteorologist Phil Schwartz. This is ABC 7 News Sunday morning.
We were wanting to go outside this morning to grill, but frankly, it's a little too cold. So Ted Reeder brought his electric grill inside to cook up his tasty burger recipe. It comes from his award-winning book, King of the Q's Blue Plate Barbecue. And Ted is here this morning. Ted, nice to have you here.
Nice to have you.
Welcome. This is a great book. You got great recipes and nothing low-fat, right?
No, there's lots of low-fat in there.
There is?
But there's all kinds of stuff that makes food fun.
Oh,
and that's
good.
What Blue Plate Barbecue is all about, is having fun with your food. And when it comes to a burger, it's about making your belly always happy, all right? You got to keep it happy.
Absolutely.
So the truth is, when you bite into a burger, the juices and the fat should run down your chin, hit the bottom of your chin, do a triple backflip, land on your belly, and the juices flow right into your belly button. That's what it's all about.
This is a man after my own heart.
Okay?
I like this.
So
okay, show us how to do this.
This is the better butter burger.
The better butter burger.
So we're going to add a little bit of butter into this burger, okay? Because most meat comes, it's lean ground beef.
Right.
And you know what? You need some fat, because fat is flavor.
Okay.
Me, I'm delicious. You're a little skinnier, not as tasty as I am, okay?
So you're adding fat to the burger.
Just a little bit, okay?
All right. And what is that?
This is my barbecue seasoning, Rob, and you can put any kind you want. The key is, when you're seasoning, completely cover the meat, then you know you've got enough seasoning.
Now, Give us a clue as to a couple things that are in here.
There is some brown sugar, some salt. You've got a little bit of garlic, paprika, chili, cumin, curry. It's what I call my bone dust.
It smells good.
Now, you mix your burger up, and I use rubber gloves, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And you got to keep it going. Now, once you do that, you form it. You don't need to add onion. You don't need to add egg into it. You don't need breadcrumbs.
Okay.
It's nice and simple. Okay, I'm going to set that over there.
Yeah. All right.
All right. Now, you form it into a ball. Your meat needs to be very cold because you want to keep the fat into the meat. If it's warm, the fat comes out. Lose the flavor.
All right.
Throw it down.
Okay? Wham.
Now we form it. All right. This is about a 6-ounce patty.
6 ounces. Okay.
1 inch thick. Ready to go.
Ready for grilling?
Ready for grilling. But normally I'd put them back in the fridge, let them set up for about an hour.
Okay.
But we're good to go here. Now I'll just take that.
And you've already been doing a little bit of grilling over here.
That's it, because burgers take a bit of time. Okay.
And you like to grill them, I was reading, about 12 minutes on each side?
That's it. And not on high. You don't always have to cook on high heat. Turn it down. The bottom line is, the longer it takes to cook, the more beer you get. All right? So you take a little bit of beer.
I'm following you now. Okay.
All right? And sometimes your burgers need to be basted with a little bit of beer.
Okay.
Because beer and burgers makes your belly happy.
And then do you drink a little while you're grilling?
Of course you do.
Okay,
that's how it always comes together.
Yes.
Now, the assembly of the crazy burger, okay? This is my extremely ludicrous burger.
Okay.
And I have this on my menu at my restaurant in the Dominican Republic.
All right.
Because it's warmer there.
Well, show us how to make this ludicrous burger. It starts with a grilled cheese sandwich.
Grilled cheese sandwich on the bottom.
Love that.
All right, sometimes you need something healthy, so we'll start with a tomato.
Okay.
That's the only healthy part of this, okay?
Just one slice of tomato.
Then you take your burger.
The butter burger.
The butter burger. If you want, you can add some more cheese. If you wanted to melt the cheese, you can.
Okay.
Then you take a little bit of back bacon. This is Canadian back bacon because I'm a Canadian.
In case you don't have enough meat on there.
Right.
You got some ham.
Right. Because sometimes you might want to add a sausage. If you need a sausage. Because the bottom line is...
You've got to draw the line somewhere.
Okay? If you're going to do it, do it. So then let's say you got your sausage, right? Then you got your burger.
Again?
Yeah. Are you insane? Yes, I am. All right? Then you top it with extra cheese. Sometimes you might like pickle, okay?
Okay.
Then you got the Canadian bacon that goes back on top of it. Now you need some grilled onions to top that part up, okay? And then would you like asparagus? Because sometimes you like vegetables on it. All right, you dip right down in here. You might even want a fried egg
top.
Take the other grilled cheese sandwich.
You know what? We're going to take a little break here. He's going to finish this sometime in the next hour. Oh, that's the little toothpick for it. Very nice.
There is your extremely ludicrous burger.
That is ludicrous. That's sweet. Thank you, Tim, very much. Again, his book is called King of the Q's Blue Plate Barbecue. It is available right now. And for more information and a copy of this ludicrous recipe, log on to abc7chicago.com, roll over extra info, and click on Weekend News. Not even going to try to bite into that.
Well, if
it
you
might
want,
hurt.
You can also just check me out at tedreeder.com.
Very good. Thanks, Ted. We'll be right back. Stay with us.